A local surgeon stripped of her scalpel as the hospital she works at refuses to allow her to operate. The hospital says the decision is professional. The surgeon says it's personal.
St. Mary Mercy Hospital in Livonia prides itself on its doctors, nurses, and its reputation. To make sure they stay at the top of their game, they monitor the results of surgeries and surgeons. Officials say this surgeon, Dr. Lakeisha Brintley, was not making the grade, so they revoked her privileges, refusing to let her operate in their hospital.
Good morning, Miss Reeves.
Good morning.
How are you today?
Lakeisha Brintley grew up in a rough neighborhood, but was determined to defy the odds. She became a standout student whose hard work took her to college and medical school.
I went to Highland Park High School, raised in a Detroit public school system, went to Howard University for undergraduate college, and then went on to University of Michigan for medical school.
From a poor neighborhood to a graduate of one of America's top medical schools, she says she became a surgeon to save lives.
I was very much interested in medicine. I had a mother who was quite sickly, and during the courses and the many visits for her hospitalizations, I always knew I wanted to help people in the community.
She has performed hundreds of surgeries, but according to documents from her lawsuit against the hospital, when serious complications came up in one specific surgery, everything changed. Dr. Brintley's attorney, Daryl Seegers, claims the event, a vascular injury, was within the average rate of surgical incidents.
Immediately after the surgery, the staff there at the hospital told Dr. Brintley they wanted her to resign. She said, well, I didn't do anything wrong. Why would I resign?
The hospital, concerned for the safety of its patients, put Dr. Brintley under review, her surgery supervised by other surgeons. Following the review, the doctor was pulled from the operating room, her privileges revoked. The hospital says it went strictly by the book. Seeger says Dr. Brintley was treated differently from other surgeons in similar situations.
There have been other general surgeons at St. Mary Hospital who have had the identical vascular injury that Dr. Brintley encountered in January of 2008, and nothing was done to them. Absolutely nothing.
Dr. Brintley is stunned. She says her reputation is everything.
It's heartbreaking, and It's of all the work that you do and the hard work you do to put into something like a career in surgery and to have to deal with someone taking it away from you wrongfully, it's painful, and it's even more painful to talk about.
Her surgical skills, excellent.
I want these allegations to be known because it should not have happened. A good surgeon in a good community providing good care.
Her childhood dreams derailed, but insisting only temporarily.
If ever there's a time where an unjust action comes against you and you know you're right, you stand your ground and you make sure that you fight.
Her lawyer says he has audio tape recordings that support the claims that the hospital was satisfied with Dr. Brintley's skill.
We have two separate sets of rules for, you know, African-American female physicians at St. Mary's, and another set of rules for non-African-American male physicians at St. Mary's Hospital.
Dr. Brintley says she won't run from the accusations, claiming she has nothing to hide.
That's what I would tell my children, is that if you know that you're doing the right thing, truth and justice is on your side, and that's what we have to depend on.
The hospital's official statement says sex, race, creed, and national origin have nothing to do when it comes to making staffing decisions at the hospital. Both hospital officials and the surgeons say they look forward to proving their case in court. Kevin Dietz, Defenders.